Why the two of them, Mrs. Reynolds? Mum and Sean? Why both of them?
I don't know, Alice. Is there anyone you'd like us to ring?
How'd you know it was her?
Pardon?
How'd you know it was Lou what done it?
The police picked her up shortly afterwards.
Think she'll be back here soon.
Alice, I understand how you must feel.
No, you don't, so save your breath. I'm gonna kill her. Nothing's gonna stop me.
You got problems, Joan. You're hiding behind so many walls that one day they're gonna come tumbling down on top of you. I've seen crack-ups and they're not nice. And the way you're going, you're a prime candidate for one.
You just stick to being Mr. Fix-It.
Our kid's dead and she's not even sorry she did it.
Maybe she isn't sorry Linda's no longer in pain, but I'll bet it's cutting her up inside.
Yeah, maybe, I don't know. Do you reckon she's gonna be all right in there?
I'll do my best.
But what if anybody finds out?
That will be a disaster, mate. A bloody disaster.
Come and stand on the white line, please. Your name is Catherine Lorraine Maxwell, is that correct?
Yes.
You've been remanded to Wentworth Detention Centre on a charge of first-degree murder until such time as your hearing. Is that correct?
Yes.
Right, come over here, please. Take off your jewellery, empty your pockets and give me a mender.
Into the shower, Williams.
I don't need to, I'm clean.
Oh, come on.
Oh, that was your day off.
Came in to get my briefcase. Left it last night.
Oh, why didn't you phone? I would have dropped it over to you.
Oh, that's okay. Hand around?
Yes, yes. She's in her office. You better hurry if you want to see her, though. She wants to see these new arrivals in a minute.
Won't take a sec.
Right. As soon as I've made a list of your effects, you should check them and then sign for them, all right?
Seeing as you've got the car for the day, I thought you might like to pick me up after work. Thank you. Yes?
Oh, see you a minute.
Okay. See you then. You too.
Well, what can I do for you on your day off?
Well, I came in to pick something up. Noticed that Maxwell woman in reception.
Oh, yes, I was just about to phone to see if she'd come.
Yes, well, that talk I said I'd have with the women, I probably should do it now before she's put in with them.
Can't it wait till you come in tomorrow?
Well, it could, but it might seem less like an official lecture if they see me off duty.
If you like. It'll have to wait till they finish work, though.
Fine.
Might help avert trouble at that. Goodness knows we'll have enough of that when Williams is back amongst the women.
Kelly?
No option there. She'll have to be kept as far away from the others as possible. That's if we want to keep her alive.
The guy was scared witless. He just planted his foot, went straight over the cliff without looking at a 6 feet of mud.
Oh, serves him right. Still, if it had been me, I'd have been scared too. I mean, bikers look really...
Oh, how can you say that? Look at me. How did you go?
I'm going to knock the bitch's head off if the freak hadn't stopped me.
Well, she can't be too crooked. She's cheeking you.
She's got nothing to lose now, though, has she?
Plenty if we get to her first.
Oh, but if she's being guarded...
I don't care what it takes. I'm going to get that bitch for what she did to Jess.
Well, don't forget Lurch.
Yeah, poor Alice. Wish there was something we could do to cheer her up.
Well, maybe there is, eh, Lex?
Hmm? Oh, yeah.
What? Don't you remember? This afternoon, Santa's sending back our little toy car with the full cargo.
Do you really think that'll work? I mean, what if he can't control it from that far away? And what if a screw sees you?
Will you just leave it to me? By tonight, we'll be cheering Lurch up and anyone else who's in for a good time.
Yeah, well, put me down for double.
Oh, Lex, I wish you wouldn't.
Oh, who's the party pooper? And don't forget, I don't want Nancy hearing anything about it, OK?
Who are you staring at, mug? Ah. Hello, Bong! Hi.
How you going, Odd?
Oh, good. Dan been doing wheel stands on your face. Does he look as bad as you?
Yeah, worse probably. Anyway, I don't look that bad.
Well, they wouldn't take you in a wrecking yard with a guy like that. Have you got the stuff?
Of course I got the bloody stuff, you old bin. Hop on, Rita, the girls are waiting. Ah! Stop sticking that bloody thing into me.
Oh, sorry, boy, boy.
I have to warn you, you could be in for a difficult time. The women are somewhat unforgiving when the killing of a child's involved.
I expected as much.
With all the media attention your case has attracted, you'll have to assume that they do know who you are and what you've been charged with. Now, admittedly, we don't have the staff to watch you 24 hours a day, but officers are on regular patrol.
I appreciate what you're saying, but I am prepared for the worst. After what I've done, I'd be foolish to think otherwise.
Thought you were off today.
I'm waiting to talk to the women.
Imagine what you want to talk to that lot about.
I'm hoping I can stop them being too rough on the Maxwell woman.
Yeah, what's it to you?
Two sides to every story. It's only fair to make them aware of that.
Woman got sick of looking after a child, so she killed it. End of story.
We're supposed to prevent trouble, not condone it.
Oh, we'll do our best to protect her, all right, but it won't do any good. The woman murdered her child. She's admitted it.
Whatever she might have done, that's up to the courts and not the women or you to judge her.
Oh, we are playing the white knight, aren't we?
I think it's only fair to make an effort and to prevent trouble.
As far as I'm concerned, she's not worth any effort. Whatever she's done, she's only got herself to blame.
Right, well, here you are. Dinner will be served later this afternoon. If there's anything you want. Right.
Hey, Mrs. Morris, spare a fag for an old digger? Oh, I forgot. You haven't got any vices, have you?
Just quieten down or you'll be on another charge.
Enjoying the view? Here you've got the royal suite. Hey, I'm talking to you.
Who's that?
Williams came in with you. Who do you think?
Look, I'm sorry. I really don't feel like talking.
You're going to need friends, lady, so you better start feeling like it. Stay on my good side and you might be all right.
What do you care what happens to me?
There's some pretty heavy ladies in here. Rita the beater for a start. In here for beating the stuffing out of some tart she caught with her bloke. And McCormack, the goody-goody one, religious. Smashed her old man's head in, that's how religious she is. There's plenty more where they came from. That's the trouble with these places, they're full of crims. You and I don't belong here.
I'm prepared to cope.
So you better be, because it ain't going to be no picnic. I reckon you and I ought to stick together, right?
They should be here any minute. Meg's hurrying them up.
Right, ladies, I just hope it does some good, that's all.
I'm sure it will.
Come on, what's going on, Mrs. Reynolds?
We'll find out in a minute.
The civvies were here. We got two boss cookies
and one. Stop wasting time. Move along.
I bet it's got something to do with Kelly coming back.
That or they're trying to rattle us with a volleyball comp.
No, Mr. Moran looks very serious.
All right, ladies, quiet, please.
This better be good. You're using up our rec time, you know.
Mr. Moran's come in specially to talk to you. Let's not have any unnecessary interruptions. All yours.
Thank you.
Like your jacket, Mr. Moran.
I thought you might, Patterson. That's why I wore it in, especially. Yeah, all right. Now, I won't take up much of your time, but what I have to say is important. Now, some of you would know that I was in Vietnam for a while. Well, I was one of the lucky ones. I got back in one piece. I never married, and I've managed to stay pretty healthy. Some of the other blokes haven't been quite that lucky.
What's this got to do with us?
I'm getting to it. The fact is that some of the blokes who fought up there are having a pretty rough time of it. You see, there were chemicals used as defoliants.
What's a defoliant?
It's a poison. It kills bushes and trees and stuff.
It was used to stop the Viet Cong living off the land, and a lot of it was sprayed where the Australian troops were operating.
Has this got something to do with that Sheila was on the news last night?
If you mean Kath Maxwell, yes. She's in solitary. Now, I know how you feel about mothers killing their children.
Yeah, we hate the bitches.
But apparently, Maxwell's husband is one of the veterans affected by these defoliants.
Well, it still doesn't give her the right to kill the kid.
It's her job to look after the little nipper.
Yeah, I mean, once she had the kid, shouldn't she have gone through with it?
They've got a point.
Come on, quieten down, ladies. Shh.
I think you owe Mr. Moran a fair hearing.
Now, it seems that the mother was totally devoted to the child. For 5 years, she sat trying to help in every way she knew possible until finally she couldn't bear the suffering any longer. The painkillers weren't working. The prognosis was hopeless. Now, I just wonder what any of you would have done in the same situation.
Hey, Bob! Come quick!
Oh, hang on!
Never mind about hang on. Come on, quick! The fucker's on the outside.
What?
The guard. He's supposed to be patrolling from the inside. The bugger's on the outside.
Well, nothing we can do about it now. Just have to time it right.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe it'd be a good idea to just ride up, chuck it over the fence. It'd be much simpler.
Yeah, a lot simpler, right? Wake up the whole bloody neighbourhood, chuck a bag of coke 10 feet in the air and ride off again. Oh, I mean, no one's going to notice that, are they?
Who's to say who's going to notice that bloody thing?
Because it's the last thing they'll be looking for. Relax, will you, all right? Still getting the hang of this thing. Ground's bumpier than I thought. Anyway, if they do see us, we'll just get on our bikes and ride off. Not going to catch us from this far off, are they?
No, I suppose not. Oh, God, you got to hand it to the old Reed. She's a smart Sheila. About time they was out of here, isn't it?
Yeah, been worrying me too. Hope there hasn't been a foul up there in.
Oh, goodness.
Yeah, but once she had the kid, shouldn't she have been prepared to go through with it?
Yeah, but didn't you say she went to the hospital every day?
That's right.
Yeah, well, I reckon any bitch who'd do something like that deserves what she's got coming to her.
No, it's not fair to judge other people. I mean, if you were in her place, you might do the same thing.
What do you reckon, Ray?
Well, it depends. If she really did it to put the kid out of its suffering, then I can't say I wouldn't do the same thing myself. But if she did it just to make things easier... Well, I wouldn't take too kindly to that.
She wasn't doing it for the kid. She was copping out.
Yeah. I mean, at least Jess gave me to someone she thought would look after me. I mean, couldn't she have done that?
It was different. You weren't sick.
Yeah, but if the father was in Vietnam and if it was chemicals that caused the trouble, I think we're all partly responsible.
How do you figure that one?
Well, because we were the ones they were defending.
Ball, it was the politicians who sent them there.
Yeah, it's all their fault.
Ladies, I think we're straying from the point. I just want you all to think about what you might have done in Kath Maxwell's position and not be too quick to condemn. And that's about all I've got to say.
Thank you, ladies.
Hurry up.
I think you might have got through. Some of them, anyway.
Well, they were talking about it.
Well, let's hope so.
Pity we're going to lose you, Bob. Not many officers would care enough to come in like that on their day off.
Well, actually, I've decided to withdraw my transfer application. That's if it hasn't gone through already.
As a matter of fact, it hasn't. Glad to hear it.
And I'll second that. That's about the first bit of good news we've had in here all day.
Bloody Moran, now we're late. What if they've decided to go home?
No way. Bong wants the sale. They'll be out there somewhere.
Hey, there's Reed.
About time. She looking for us?
Yeah.
Beauty. Go, you bugger!
Bloody magic, isn't it?
Oh, the magic's inside those little bags, all right?
Beauty, here it comes.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going over by the shed. Any screws come over, you hit them off,
right.
Okay?
Jeez.
Get rid of her, will you? She's the last person I want hanging around.
What am I going
to
say?
Use your brains. Just get rid of her.
G'day, Nance. What you up to?
Well, I just want to speak to Rita about what Mr. Moran said.
Right, look, did Lurch catch up with you?
Alice, no. Why?
Oh, I don't know. It seemed real important, but...
Oh,
Well, where is she?
I think she went in the kitchen, something about asking the cake.
All right, well, I better go and see what she wants then.
Yeah, good idea.
Go, baby, it's working like a beaut, aren't?
God, the guard's coming.
What? Oh, hell!
Can't see this yet.
Still make it. Go, baby, go!
Station 4 to gate, come in. Station 4 to gate, come in.
God, what are you doing? You're going the wrong bloody way.
It's not me, the bloody thing's out of control.
Oh, God, you're running straight into the screw.
Station 4 to gate, come in. Station 4 to gate, come in. Trevor, can you hear me? Oh, what the hell's wrong with this damn thing?
Bloody thing's stuffed!
Flying up on you, is it?
Hey? Yeah, one of the switches is broken.
Hey, are you going to be in the staff versus us at volleyball match? I reckon you're going to need a few blokes if you plan on beating us. So we've had this special training program going, you know? 40 push-ups every morning.
Well, the trouble is, I don't know the rules. Probably get in the way.
Oh, no way. I mean, if these morons can learn how to do it, you sure can. I mean, the whole aim of the game is to keep the ball off the ground, you know?
Beauty, Reedy's got it.
Good on you, Reed.
Daddy, baby.
Have to check that.
Fair enough.
Well, from the way the women were talking, I'd say that your little speech didn't make much of an impression.
Not everyone seems to share that opinion.
It's all been tried before, you know. And by better than you. Oh, you can't reason with that lot. They're incapable of it.
Won't find out unless we give them a chance, will we?
Well, I wouldn't hold my breath. The only thing that motivates that lot is hate. Hate for anything that's decent and civilized.
They wouldn't have that on their own, would they?
What's that supposed to mean?
You know exactly. Maybe if you tried being a human being once in a while, you might do us all a favor and unload that giant chip on your shoulder. Might even pick up a friend or two. Thank you. Oh, by the way, I've withdrawn my transfer application. I've decided I don't want to leave Wentworth after all. I enjoy your company too much.
You know, that was marvellous of Bob talking to the women. Such an emotional issue.
Yes, we'll just have to see what happens.
Do you think there'll be any trouble when Maxwell gets out of solitary?
Connors is keeping an open mind. I'm hoping it'll rub off on the others.
Mm.
And in the meantime, I'll be doubling the corridor patrols near his cell. I'm not taking any chances.
What about Patterson? Being pregnant herself won't help.
No. Jenkins is a worry, too. I think she might be using this issue to hit back about her own family's death.
Anne, I've been looking for you. Be okay if I spend this afternoon shift in maternity? Apparently, some of the women have heard about Bob's talk.
What was the reaction?
Not good. So I thought I might try and put over some of Bob's points myself.
Good idea. We'll have to make sure Maxwell's kept well away from the other women during exercise periods, too, when she gets out of solitary.
Right. Williams isn't wasting any time making her presence felt. I must have told her to shut up at least a dozen times this afternoon.
I'll have a chat with her before she goes back with the women.
You would have thought her time in Blackmore would have knocked some of the cockiness out of her, but she's as arrogant as ever.
Got no reason to be. Connors would probably string her up, given half a chance.
Perhaps it's a stroke of luck that Maxwell arrived with her. All that discussion about her keeps the women's minds off Williams and Kelly.
Hey, you're not going to sleep on me, are you?
Please, I'm really very tired.
Look, I'm just talking to you for your own good. You've got to watch yourself in here. Hey, am I talking to myself or what?
I just need to get some rest.
Yeah, I suppose you're better. You're going to have plenty to think about once they toss you in with Connor's mob. Oh, don't worry. Stick with me. You'll be all right. We'll look after each other, eh?
Lovely, sir. That's the idea. You're really getting the hang of that now. Try and keep it up. That's it. Oh, beautiful. Keep it going. Oh, never mind. Okay, next serve. Ready to go,
mate? Finished icing Merv and Joyce's cake.
Good on you. How's it look?
Right, I guess. Lex came in.
Oh.
She reckoned Nance wanted to see me. What was all that about?
Yeah, nearly sprung me in the middle of his special delivery from Bongo.
Oh, yeah, I forgot. Did you get the goodies in okay?
Sure as hell did, sister.
Oh.
We'll organise a snort after dinner. That ought to set you up for the night, eh?
You got it on ya?
There's no doubt. Lex's taking it in to stash it. Look, I thought you and me could get in a bit of extra throwing practice for volleyball. Give that bitch Kelly a bit of a fright at the same time. You in it?
Too bloody right.
Why did you send me in to see Alice? She didn't know anything about it.
Well, that's not what she said.
Well,
I mean,
it was supposed to be a joke. It wasn't very funny.
I could have got it wrong.
Which one
up? There.
Okay.
Do you want to go first?
You bet. A bit of luck, a bit of glass might cut her bloody throat.
Bugger
it! Never mind,
keep trying.
I'm gonna get you, Kelly!
Okay.
Oh, I'm gonna get you!
Are you all right,
Kelly?
No,
they're trying to kill me!
Kelly, you're dead! 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 Kelly, you're dead!
I won't have you taking the law into your own hands. Did you stop to think what could have happened to Sister Hall or Mrs. Barry?
We weren't trying to hurt anyone. Just give Kelly a scare. I'm not about to
what
sit around and wait.
What was reckless and irresponsible, like most things you've been involved in lately?
Oh, it wasn't her fault, Mrs. Reynolds. I was
I
the one who...
I know very well where the blame lies. You'll both lose phone calls and visiting rights for 1 week. You'll pay for the broken window out of your wages, and you'll both scrub out the shower block. Jenkins, I know this is a difficult time for you, but this sort of thing won't bring your family back.
How'd you feel? Knowing Kelly was lying up there safe. After what she'd done to them. I could kill her with my own bare hands.
I've warned you, Jenkins. I will not tolerate talk of revenge. Is that quite clear?
So much for bloody justice.
Got such a fright when that rock came flying through the window. There's glass absolutely everywhere.
I can't see the governor doing anything about it.
Of course she will.
Here with a boyfriend who's one of Connor's bikey mates? Not likely.
I will take that. Thank you.
Thought you lot were supposed to be protecting me.
You're alive, aren't you?
It was no thanks to you. Oh, and you can tell Alice that her brother's a creep and so's her old lady.
You mean were?
Well, what did you mean to kill him? The bastard forced me into it.
Oh, save it for the jury.
That makes you feel real good, doesn't it, having someone to walk all over?
Kelly, I do not enjoy dealing with scum like you.
Oh, bull, you don't. That's how you get your kicks, isn't it? You haven't had a girlfriend since
you
my
shut your filthy mouth! Stop that, the both of you! I think you better go.
Go on, Ferguson. Deny it, I dare you!
That is enough. I'll have you put in solitary whether you're sick or not.
Hey, Lurch, catch.
Oh, jeez, what are you doing?
Got to get in practice for the volleyball match. Come on, chuck it back.
Oh, yuck, and practically walk back by itself.
Toss it, will you? I've got to sharpen me reflexes.
Yeah. Gotcha! Oh. All right, you two, you're both on charges.
Oh, dear, Miss Ferguson, you already gave me 120 years last time.
Oh, I've warned you before, Connors. This time you've had it.
What do you reckon?
Oh, bloody hell, you stupid buggers! If I want to wash, I'll do it myself.
Hey, did you hide the stuff okay?
Yeah, space shuttle's ready to blast off.
Good times, here we come, eh, Lurch?
Yeah, right.
Hey, Nance wasn't too happy about me sending her to find Lurch. Reckon I've been playing some sort of practical joke.
It's too bad. If she knew we had coke, she'd throw a wobbly for sure.
Oh, but she's still one of the gang, Bart.
I love the old Nance as much as you do.
Hey, some of the girls are asking when their orders will be filled.
I reckon we should give it a test run first. Start selling tomorrow.
Oh, I'm dying for a biff.
Keep me mind off Kelly.
When and where?
Soon as dinner's finished, your place.
1800 hours, blast off!
Woo! Roger, we'll go over and out.
Ground control, this is Megan's floor!
You read me?
Pursued by hostile aliens!
Hey, Kelly, it's precious, Lurch. Hey, are you sure you won't have some?
No, I just chucked like when I had that grass.
This is different. We look sick.
Sick of screws, maybe.
Sick of the freak.
And getting up early every morning.
Working in the laundry. Oh, when'll they bring in the other lot?
Go easy, Lurch. That stuff, we need something left over to sell.
I reckon she's got a vacuum cleaner shoved up her nose.
Oh, it looks like she's going to empty it. Turn your bloody head away. Look, I know you're feeling rotten, but there's no need to overdo it.
Yeah, all right.
Joan! Come on, are you sure you weren't changing mine?
No, thanks anyway. And you shouldn't be having it either, Lex.
No sweat means it's more for us.
Maybe Madam would prefer a glass of cognac.
Madam forgot her glass.
You need the bloody glass, eh?
Got there.
Bingo, whiskey aged in rubber.
Bloody hell.
Gina liberated one of your tennis balls. Wanted off in a car game.
A rotten bugger. I ought to slap a wrist for that.
I've been saving it for emergencies like now. Go on, get into you.
Well, maybe Reed ought to have it.
No, you go for it. Put hairs on your chest.
You sure you don't want it?
Nah, we're a gang. We share everything. Was she as bad as this last time?
This rubber tastes just like whiskey. Is it the other way around?
Well, are you supposed to drink it, not eat it?
Talk about one-pot screamers.
Are you suggesting I can't hold my liquor?
I'm saying I've seen newts that were sober in you, sweetheart.
Seen what?
Newts, you know, like... Oh, forget
music,
it.
Music, that's what this party needs. Something real dancing.
Hey, not too loud. I'll have the screw sniffing round.
Yeah, play something soft and romantic.
Oh, get out. Next thing she'll be dreaming about Stevie Boy.
What's wrong with that?
Nothing. I might even join ya.
Our relationship is one of true love. It's based on a coming together of the spirits.
You've had enough spirits for one night.
I am not drunk.
Hey, here comes Nance. Everyone act normal.
What's wrong with thinking about it anyway? Jeez. I was just passing by. I thought I'd see what you were all up to.
Just dagging around?
Yeah.
Anyone want a game of cards or something?
No, not for me.
Me neither.
Right, well, I'll see you all later then.
Oh, geez, come on, come have a dance.
Thank you.
The only reason they play golf is to wiggle their backsides in public. Right, Don?
Yeah, mate.
I mean, look at Blondie up there, dressed up like a film star. Probably come straight from the hairdressers.
Excuse me, would you mind keeping quiet? I'm trying to watch that.
Watch what? The fashion stakes? I suppose you think some of them could give Jack Nicklaus a run for his money.
Oh, come on, don't be ridiculous. They're professional golfers, and they deserve a little more than being patronised by you.
You can't deny it, though, can you? Look, nothing against you, lady, but blokes are stronger than women. It's a fact of life.
Fact of life, is it?
Yeah.
You, wouldn't care to prove that point, would you?
What are you doing?
Well, what does it look like? Don't tell me you're afraid to show me how strong you are.
Okay, come on. Look, no need to get upset. Like I said, nothing personal.
No. I'd just like to see you prove your point. I'm sure your friend there would, too.
OK. You're on. Do the honours, Don.
Ready? Go.
Now, you were saying?
Well, you certainly put the local chauvinist in his place, all right.
Oh, I just wanted to watch the tournament in peace, that's all.
Fair enough. Could I buy you a drink, if I'm not imposing, that is?
No. No, not at all. Scotch and soda would be very nice, thank you.
Good.
Gotcha, second time!
Quick, we're in a hole in the floor, will you, Lurch? I can't concentrate.
I've got to keep moving. As soon as I stop, I think about Kelly, what she did to Mum and Sean.
You're making me dizzy.
Well, I have to do something.
Oh, I give up.
Come on, do you want to go with the chair?
No, I've got to go live on work. Well, make sure the screws don't see you. You'll be gone if they get you to walk in a straight line.
Maybe I should go with her.
I can't wait any longer. I'm going to kill her.
And we're a gang, right? And we all stick together through good times and bad. It's going to be good, okay? Let us live as one.
We'll be for... Oh, Julie.
Oh, yes.
I can't stay for very long. I've got to go and water the horse. You know, go to the toot.
Toot.
Julie, have you been drinking?
Nancy, what makes you think that?
Well, it's really quite obvious.
Oh. Well, it was just a couple of drops. Three, maybe. It was medicinal, you know.
Oh, I see. And the rest of the gang been drinking too?
No, because it was just enough for me.
Well, what are they high on then? They must have been taking something.
You're asking an awful lot of questions, Nance.
It's drugs, isn't it? And is that why Lexie sent me inside from the exercise yard earlier? Was that all part of shutting me out too?
Look, I've got to go to the tour. I'm going to bust. I'll talk to you later, all right?
There you go. Look, if you're not waiting for anyone else, I wouldn't mind joining you, if that's okay.
Please.
Thank you. Looks like he's more into football than golf. Do you play at all?
Oh, I used to a little, but I don't get much of a chance these days, I'm afraid.
Yeah, I know what you mean. I ended up forcing myself. Joined the local club.
I didn't know there was one.
Well, it's more a social club, really. Play golf once a week, and if anyone doesn't turn up, you get an extra handicap added to your scorecard the following week.
Oh, no.
That's right. And honestly, my game is so bad, I do not need anything put on top of it. Well, cheers, eh?
Cheers.
Steve, what are you doing here?
I just came in to fix a window in the infirmary.
Thought I was dreaming.
Are you all right? You're a bit wobbly.
I feel great.
Oh, no wonder you're half to the gills.
Steve, did you know that you've got a really cute nose?
Julie.
Oh, look, why don't you and I nick into a cell and sort of talk for a bit, eh?
Look, I can't think of a faster way for you to lose your parole.
It's just you and me, come on.
Stop it, it's not worth it.
Don't you love me anymore?
Of course I do, but this is absolutely massive. Quick, get out of here.
Oh, Steve, window fixed?
Yeah, just on my way out.
Oh, like to join me for a coffee before you go?
No, thanks. You go ahead.
Oh, all right, suit yourself. See you tomorrow.
$100 to bail him out! It was the dearest drink I'd ever...
You've all been taking drugs,
haven't you? What gives you that idea?
Well, I may be old-fashioned, but I am not stupid.
Oh, look, we didn't want you getting upset about it.
Yeah, we'll try and talk us out of it.
Or we didn't think you'd want to know about us getting the coke in here.
So it's cocaine. Well, I won't deny I am against that, especially when unborn children are concerned.
Here we go.
Oh, it's just a bit of fun, Nance.
I know, and I don't want to seem like a spoilsport, but I just wish you trusted me a bit more.
Oh, it wasn't because we thought you'd lag. Yeah. We just didn't think there was any point in you getting involved.
Yeah. So you treated me like a fool, and you sent me around on wild goose chases half the day. I thought we were supposed to be friends, members of a gang.
We are, aren't we?
Yeah, worrying is forever, right?
Yeah. Yeah. Well, if it means being excluded just because I've got different opinions, I'm not sure I want to be part of it.
Oh. Jeez!
You, Nance, would go right off a block if she found out about the coke.
She's just feeling left out, that's all.
I don't know, maybe we should have told her. I just don't want to give her the chance to go lecturing us.
I reckon we ought to go talk to her.
Yeah, she's all right, the old Nance. I hate seeing her unhappy like that.
I'm sorry, love, the bar's closed.
Jeez, you look like you've seen a ghost.
I was nearly sprung.
What?
Steve covered for me.
Steve?
What's he doing here at night?
Oh, I came to fix that window. I ran into him by accident.
That's a good one.
It's true. He knew I'd been drinking. He was real mad. He reckons I'll do me parole if they catch me.
Well, that's the last of the grog in here.
Yeah, well, I'm glad. Jeez, it gives me a headache. We're on our way to see Nancy. Are you coming? I think she knows about the coke.
Yeah, well, she's already given us a big speech.
Yeah, reckon she's being left out.
Out?
Of the Warriors.
Come on, let's go and chomp on a bit of humble pie. Oh.
No, the old Stevie boy ain't too bad. That's the second time he's covered for it.
Just protecting his merchandise.
Yes, I hope he still wants me after the fall I made of myself.
Life in prison's taking its toll tonight. My friends in the gang have deserted me after I discovered they were using cocaine.
Gang wants to talk to you, Nance.
I won't tell anyone about the drugs, if that's what you're worried about.
We're sorry we conjured this arvo when we brought the coke in.
Yeah, it was a real dirty trick. What we're trying to say is we stuffed up, so we've come to apologise.
Now, I don't take back anything I said about the drugs.
We're not asking you to.
We just should have trusted you, that's all.
A couple of fellas in the Conquerors never touched the stuff. It didn't bother anyone. As a matter of fact, they were the biggest loonies in the club.
You're going to come back in again, eh? Well, as long as you're not going to try to convince me that I'm wrong.
We won't if you won't, right, girls?
No, it's all right.
We want you to, Nan, so the gang stays together.
So what do you reckon? You're not going to let us down and tell us to get lost, are you? We only just got you doing the war cry properly.
Warriors!
This particular hole has got a nasty dog leg in it. Never managed better than a double bogey. I had no reason to think this time was going to be any different, right? So I took out my two wood, whoosh, straight into the trees. Rattle, 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 rattle. Now, you won't believe this. Out it comes, onto the fairway, dong, 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 dong. Finishes up on the edge of the green, and I sink the putt.
Oh, no.
It was the first birdie I ever got, and at the most difficult hole on the golf course. It was terrific.
Oh, you really enjoy your game.
Yeah, I do. Whoever invented it's genius, you know, because it's good exercise, a lot of skill involved. And you play it with really nice people. Really nice. Tell me, how did you come to learn the game?
Oh, well, my father was a military man. And he just loved it, played every chance he got. I suppose some of it rubbed off.
Yeah. I used to be an Air Force man myself, up a few years ago.
Really? Why did you leave?
I lost interest. No, I used to wake up in the morning and think about 8 hours flying a desk, so I decided to give it up.
What you mean?
I restore antiques these days. Chairs, tables, that sort of thing. It's always been my hobby, and it earns me enough money to keep me happy. tell me, what do you do?
Oh, well, I came into a little money when my father died. I don't have to work.
Ah, lady of leisure, eh? That sounds pretty good.
Oh, I managed to keep busy.
Now, tell me. You must have a few golfing stories of your own. Now, come on, every golfer has one.
Well, I did manage to win a tournament once in my younger days.
What a tournament?
Yeah, well, it was only a local competition.
Doesn't matter, you won.
Yeah.
I'll drink to a winner.
Hello,
to use the tennis balls again, so Rick got this beaut idea about using the car.
Yeah, lucky we had the professor here to fix it.
If you spend as much time studying as you do outwitting the officers, you would all have degrees by now.
Studying? Oh, forget it. I want to know something I asked Chucky.
Yeah, it'd be good being a PhD,
but... Bloody fuddy-duddy, you mean. Nothing against your boy, Nance, but book learning never taught you how to handle a Harley on a wet road.
There you are. That'll waken you up.
Hey, got any bickies?
Oh, no. Ran out yesterday and there's no buyer.
I know where there's some.
Just what else have you been hiding
from
me?
It's not in here. It's up in their dorm.
Oh, the chocolate ones, bickies!
Yeah. Come on, we share everything. Oh, yeah, but... yourself. No buts. Just hope I don't get too hungry on the way back.
Not bloody fair. No one else is offering nothing.
Oh, I don't know. You could have 5 years of my sentence if you like.
Very good, Lurch.
What any sensible person would do.
Bloody idiot!
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside. And things were different then.